Hey, AfterBuzzers and Supernatural fans, I'm Michaela Phillips, and today I'm joined with the lovely Matt Cohen. You guys will remember him as young John Winchester in Supernatural, and we're here at the Supernatural Con. Matt, how are you going today?
I am going fantastic. What do you call the followers? AfterBuzzers? Is that what
it is? I just called them AfterBuzzers. I hope that's what they're called.
AfterBuzzers.
I mean, maybe it's a new thing. I don't know if anyone has used that before.
AfterBuzzer Army, thank you for tuning in. Enjoy this interview between myself and Michaela here. I'm going to pass it over to her because
okay,
I don't know what else
here
to
we
say
go.
Right now.
Let's jump right into it. We first see young John Winchester in season 4, episode 3, if I recall.
You recall better than I recall.
Well, I'm a huge fan, so there you go. And you also then appear again in season 5.
Yes.
Prior to shooting as young John Winchester, we were already familiar with Jeffrey Dean as John. Did you at all get the opportunity to speak with him beforehand to get like a grasp more on the character? What was like the process for you shooting that?
Unfortunately, I didn't get to speak with Jeffrey Dean Morgan, which is very unfortunate because I'm a super fanboy of you, Jeffrey. So if you're around and you want to sit down and talk, you want to go out for some coffee, I got it. It's on me. I got the script and I got the material and I figured that they were, you know, I was playing a young Jeffrey Dean and I put two and two together. You know, I'm playing him before he was him on the show that the audience knew. So I knew I had to kind of precede him in who I was and my actions. So rather than study, you know, so much of what he did on Supernatural, and I saw his stuff, but I needed something else. So I actually pulled material from him playing Denny on Grey's Anatomy. My manager, she absolutely fell in love with his performance on that, and she was like, you really should play, you know, his naive, his passion from that as, you know, a younger version of him before he's, you know, tainted and becomes this, you know, dark.
This hunter that's kind of taken on, had to kill the everything, vampires to demons to werewolves.
Right.
So that's basically where you drew then your inspiration for the character?
Yes, and I like to, the fans often ask the question, because Jeffrey Dean Morgan has brown eyes and I have green eyes, and like, what happened? How does the eye color reflect the character? I just don't understand. And I tell them, I say, well, you know, young John was just a little naive little boy, and then the darkness faded into his eyes. That was my only answer I could come up with that one. But yeah, I pulled from his other stuff. I'm a huge Jeffrey Dean fan. I think he's a fantastic actor.
He's a great actor. I've been a huge fan of Supernatural, so it's an added bonus being here today. And definitely, I agree. You both portray the character really well. Speaking of the kind of young John Winchester, this season we're kind of hearing a lot, like from fans even, and us on Supernatural After Show have been kind of circulating the idea that Sam and Dean's brother Adam might make a return. Having been young John Winchester, what do you think? Well, it's technically your son, your future son.
Right.
What do you think? Like, do you think this would be a great storyline to bring into the season?
I think bringing anybody back, anybody that's been involved in the show, anybody that can be connected to the characters that have been involved in the show, like truly connected, you know, some sort of in-depth background is a great idea. I mean, the people, the fandom, this is the most amazing fandom. They are so incredibly passionate about the characters that have been presented to them, and they continue to support these characters. They want to see more of these characters, like young John Winchester. but in all reality, it's myself, when I watch the show, I tend to like be more biased in favor of seeing repetition of the old characters.
Okay.
You know, rather it be two episodes a season or in the whole season, you know, the Crowley and Bobby, I love to see more and more and more. You know, Misha being a regular now, Castiel, it's just, we want to see more of the people we love, you know, we really do.
It's definitely a shame Bobby is no longer in it.
Yeah.
Hopefully, like, we can get some flashbacks. Speaking of, you kind of just hinted there, you're like, young John Winchester back in there. Would you love to do any more, like, kind of flashback scenes that you could definitely bring that character back into the series?
Yeah, absolutely. I often pitch, and this is the fanboy in me pitching, somehow young John coming to present day, or not extreme present day, but, like, the future of where older John existed, and them
like meeting?
Bumping into each other in some kind of weird parallel universe type of thing. I would obviously come back to the show in a second if they asked me to do anything. If they wanted, hey, Matt, would you come up here and just do craft service and cater lunch for us? It's such a wonderful program that they've put together. And I chalk it up to Jared and Jensen caring so much. They the crew is amazing, and the crew cares about every single aspect of the show. There's a reason the show is on for 10 years. You know, it's a sci-fi show with two male leads on 10 seasons. Yeah. It's crazy.
It's a real milestone. 200th episode, 10 years. Like you said, it's amazing. I for one, would love to see young John Winchester back in maybe a flashback. Yeah. Maybe if Adam then did come into this season, maybe we would see you. Who knows? Yeah. But aside from Supernatural now, I know that you also have like quite a passion for like indie projects and indie films that I've read. You also had the amazing opportunity in the past to work with Josh Schwartz, who's very notoriously known for The OC and Gossip Girl.
Yes.
Talk to me a little bit more about your other passions and the works you have in right now.
I'm absolutely head over heels in love with this business and the creativity of it. It doesn't matter what it is. I'm getting ready to direct a short that I wrote.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. It's going to star my wife. But just any piece of it. You know, you talk about Josh Schwartz. I did the OC early on in my career, one episode. Yes. And then I got to work with Josh again on a project called Rockville CA, which was one of WB's big web series. And it was just, it's amazing. The creativity, the freedom, you know, the stuff he comes up with is just brilliant stuff. You know, it's just a great time. And to be able to create on different platforms nowadays, you know, like, to be able to put something out on the web, like you could make an Instagram video, like just to have the freedom and have the access to show it to so many people, it's just a brilliant thing. I have an indie coming out called Windsor Drive, I think early next year. It's going to limited theatrical release and distribution on DVD, so you'll see that around. I just did an episode of Criminal Minds, aired last week.
Oh, awesome.
I have no idea what's tomorrow's bringing. You know, I'm not a regular on a show, so every day is something different. It's like, oh, I'm pursuing this deal.
Yeah.
There's a book series called Rune Lords out that we're in negotiations to do like a, you know, a big picture deal. But, you know, we don't know if it's going to happen.
Right.
You know, that could go to the studio level. Then they could put Channing Tatum in it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, who knows? But every day that I get to participate in any form of creativity in this business, it's a blessing of a day.
Yeah.
And the fact that there's a fandom out there like this that supports me, I haven't been on a show in 5 seasons. It's just great. I'm so thankful for them letting me discover who I really wanted to be as a man through them. It's unbelievable.
Well, you've definitely had a successful career, and a lot of the projects or shows you've done is with Warner Brothers.
Yes.
Would you ever like, because I know you kind of like to do that kind of stuff, like behind the scenes, like do you do any directing or that? Would you like to kind of work on a show with Warner Brothers at all?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, as far as directing goes, you know, there's nothing I wouldn't direct, you know, from a music video to a, you know, 1 minute short PSA, you know, it just doesn't matter. It's directing is great. I directed a couple episodes of a web series last year and it was really fun. And I'm going to make an attempt at more directing this year. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
I'm trying not to give away too many things right now that I want to say, but I just, it's like everything's in the works. So you don't want to put that energy out there like, oh, I'm doing this. And then it doesn't happen. And everybody's like, why aren't you doing that?
Well, that's definitely fair enough. We can relate. It is the business somewhat
it
as well.
It is the business.
But you know what? People can follow you. I know you have Twitter and they can keep up to everything you're doing. And to conclude this interview, I kind of wanted to ask you, since we're on the subject of Supernatural, has anything Supernatural ever happened to you? I don't know. Anything.
It has, surprisingly. And like, let me not get emotional. Let me start by saying, don't worry about what I'm going to say.
Okay.
I'm fine with it. My grandpa passed away like 3 years ago now. And literally, I spent the night in the hospital holding him as he took his last breath. Okay. I got in the car with my wife to drive home, and this is like dead serious. Like I couldn't make up the story if I wanted to. And I'm driving home, and I'm crying, I'm emotional, and all this stuff. And I'm in a brand new Cadillac that I rented, a 2014 or I guess 2012 cars a few years ago. And I'm driving, and all of a sudden, you know, it's nighttime, and the dashboard's lit up, all the gauges and whatnot. And then all of a sudden, everything blacks out in the car. All the interior lights off, gone. My wife had just said seconds before, she's like trying to, you know, help me through the situation. She's like, you know, that there's, you know, there's energy and there's things that, you know, maybe one day he'll contact you or you'll feel him around again. And I was like, okay, you know, whatever. I don't know if I really believe in all that stuff. We're driving. Everything shuts off in the dash of the car. Black. Car's still running. I'm going 60 miles an hour on the highway. And then this song starts playing. What's the song? I think it's by Kansas.
You blinking?
No, it's I closed my eyes and I slipped away. Mark, who sings that?
Oh. Boston.
Mark.
Boston, forgive me. I knew
Mark Shepard's officially in here right now.
But it was just that line. It was just that line of the song. I closed my eyes and I slipped away with the dash off, radio off, all lights off, and the line stopped. All the lights came back on and the radio was off. Couldn't make it up if I wanted to. Could not make it up. I started crying harder and harder, and that was that. So yes, Supernatural.
Absolutely. That's his. That is Matt Cohen's Supernatural moment. We are wrapping this up. Thank you, Matt, for joining us at AfterBuzz TV, and it's been a pleasure interviewing you.
Thank you, Kayla, and our AfterBuzzers, right? And
yeah,
our AfterBuzzers,
sure.
Thank you for watching, and thank you, Mark Shepherd, for filling in my lack of musical knowledge.